Hello everyone, here I am going to demonstrate refractive index and dispersive power of material of a prism using spectrometer experiment. The main objective or aim of this experiment is to determine the refractive index and dispersive power of material of a prism using spectrometer. Apparatus mainly consisting of mercury vapor lamp, prism, spirit level, magnifier or reading lens and spectrometer. Description: this is the mercury vapor lamp or polychromatic lamp, which consisting of 7 different wavelengths. This is the prism. It is made up of either with the crown glass or flint glass. This prism has 2 smooth surfaces or transparent surfaces along with the blurred surface. The top and bottom surface are also blurred or very rough. This is the magnifier or reading lens, which can be used to magnify the readings. This is the spirit level, which can be used to check the level of the spectrometer or to check the level of the prism table. To check the level of the spectrometer, it has to be placed on the surface of the spectrometer or on the surface of the prism table. When it is placed on the surface of the prism table, if the air bubble is exactly at the center, hence we can say that the spectrometer is leveled, or else we can say that the spectrometer is not leveled. In that case, with help of these 2 screws, we can adjust the level of the spectrometer. Now here the air bubble is exactly at the center, hence we can say that the spectrometer is leveled or the prism table is leveled. This is the spectrometer. This spectrometer mainly consisting of 3 parts. They are telescope, collimator and prism table. Coming to the telescope, this telescope again consisting of Ramsden eyepiece, fixed at the one end, and convex lens fixed at the other end. Here we need to know why the Ramsden eyepiece is used, why not the Huygens eyepiece? Because only in Ramsden eyepiece the vertical crosswire screen is available. This is the tangential screw or rock and pinion screw. With help of this screw, we can adjust the length of the telescope, and this telescope is attached to the lower circular disc. This is the collimator, which mainly consisting of adjustable slit fixed at the one end एंड कॉन्वेक्स लेंस फिक्सेड द अदर एंड टू एडजस्ट द विड्थ ऑफ द स्लिट ए थिक मेटल स्ट्रिप इज यूज्ड एंड टू एडजस्ट द लेंथ ऑफ द कॉलिमेटर द रॉक एंड पिनियन स्क्रू आर द टैनेंसल स्क्रू इज यूज्ड दिस कॉलिमेटर is used to render a parallel beam of light from the light source and which is rigidly fixed to the base of the instrument. This is the prism table. It mainly consisting of two circular discs. This is one and this is the second one, along with the three leveling screws in between them. It is placed exactly at the middle of the spectrometer. This is the tangential screw which can be used to adjust the height of the prism table, and these are the magnifiers which can be used to magnify the readings. In addition to these three parts, two more parts are provided in the spectrometer. They are lower circular disc and upper circular disc. On the surface of the lower circular disc, along its edges, a circular scale is provided, which is known as a main scale. For example, this is the circular scale which is located on the upper surface of the lower circular disc along its edges. This circular scale is known as a main scale, which consisting of 360 degrees. For our convenience, let us assume that this is zero, longer division. Next, this is very short, 1/2 degree. This is medium, 1 degree, 1.5 degree, 2 degrees, 2.5, 3 degrees, 3.5, 4 degrees, 4.5, 5 degrees, longer one. It means that for every 5 degrees, we have one longer division. In this main scale, the difference between any two successive divisions is equal to 1/2 degree, which is known as one main scale division value. Therefore, the value of one main scale division, the value of one main scale division, the value of one main scale division is equal to 1/2 degree. Next, this is the upper circular disc. On the surface of the upper circular disc, a short scale is rigidly fixed, which is known as a vernier scale. On the vernier scale, 30 divisions are provided. Here, one more point we have to remember, that is no units for vernier divisions. These are only divisions. Maximum number of divisions on the vernier scale equal to 30. The total number of vernier scale divisions equal to 30. Now I am going to find the least count of the spectrometer. Least count, I think we know the formula. Least count equal to one main scale division by total number of vernier scale divisions. One main scale division is 1/2 degree by total number of vernier scale divisions equal to 30, which is equal to 1/6 degrees, or which is equal to 1 minute. This is the least count of the spectrometer, and this is the way to find out the least count of the spectrometer. Now the least count value is entered in the observations, which is 1/6 degrees, or which is equal to 1 minute. And second observation is angle of prism. Since the prism is equilateral triangle, hence the angle of prism equal to 60 degrees. Procedure. In the procedure, initially we have to go for
primary adjustment. To get the primary adjustment, focus the telescope towards any object and adjust the length of the telescope until that object is clearly seen in the telescope. Then only our eye will not be strained. Here the telescope is focused towards sports complex and the length of the telescope is adjusted until that sports complex is clearly seen in the telescope. Here we can observe the sports complex name in the reverse order because of the convex lens present at the other side of the telescope. So now come back and see that the telescope and the collimator should be collinear. After that, with help of this thin metal strip, try to get the narrow slit. Now I am going to get the narrow slit with help of a thin metal strip and which can be seen in the telescope. To get the narrow slit, we have to use this screw or tangential screw. Now a thin metal strip is obtained. This can be observed through a telescope. This is the narrow slit. Just now we have obtained by adjusting the thin metal strip. After obtaining the narrow slit, place the prism on the prism table. While placing it, see that the rough surface of the prism should be either right of the collimator or left of the collimator. Now I am going to place the rough surface on the right side of the collimator. So this is the way to place the prism on the prism table. Here the rough surface is on the right side of the collimator and this edge is exactly opposite to the collimator. Now the white colored parallel ray beam is allowed to incident on the prism. When it incidents on the prism, it splits into 7 colors. To see the 7 color spectrum, the telescope is shifted towards the right side or towards the rough surface of the prism. Here, this is the spectrum just now we have obtained. This is the spectrum we have obtained in our spectrometer. In this spectrum, only 5 colors have seen. They are red, yellow, green, blue and violet. Remaining 2 colors are completely absorbed by the prism because in our physics we have a great concept, that is absorption losses. According to absorption losses concept, every object in the universe absorbs certain wavelengths when they are incident on it or when they are passing through them. In a similar manner, here the prism is absorbing the remaining 2 colors. After obtaining the spectrum, place the y-axis on any one of the 5 colors. Let it be red color. Here I am going to place the y-axis on the red color for our convenience. Now the y-axis is placed on the red color. Then go for minimum deviation. To get the minimum deviation position, the prism table is shifted or rotated towards the rough surface. Whenever the prism table is moving in the right direction, the spectrum moves in the left, but at a particular position the spectrum retraces. When the spectrum starts back or retracing, we have to stop there. That position is known as the minimum deviation position. Now I am going to rotate the prism table towards the right direction. Whenever the prism table moves in the right direction, the spectrum moves in the left, but at a particular position the spectrum retraces or starts back. When it starts back, we have to stop there. This position is known as the minimum deviation position. Once the minimum deviation position is obtained, don't disturb the prism table until the experiment is completed. And once you get the minimum deviation position for red color, that is valid for all the colors. This is the minimum deviation position. In this minimum deviation position, the light travels shortest path inside the prism. After obtaining the minimum deviation position, now use the telescope to move the y-axis. With the help of this telescope, I am going to place the y-axis on any one color of the spectrum. Let it be red color. I am going to place the y-axis on the red color with the help of this telescope. With the help of this telescope, the y-axis is placed on the red color. After placing it on the red color, take the readings or minimum deviation position readings of red color. Assume that this is the left side and this is the right side. Now I am going to take the minimum deviation position reading of red color on the left side as well as on the right side. On the left side, the main scale reading, the coincidence of 0th revision of vernier on the main scale is 44, hence the main scale reading equal to 44. Here the 0th revision of vernier is coinciding with 44th revision of main scale, hence MSR value is equal to 44. Similar, next, out of these 30 divisions, any one of the division may coincide with any one of the main scale, which is known as the vernier coincidence. In this, the 5th division of the vernier is coinciding with one of the main scale division. Similarly, on the right side, here the 0th division of vernier is coinciding with 224 of main scale, hence MSR value is 224. And next one, the 23rd division of vernier is coinciding with one of the main scale, hence the vernier scale reading equal to 23. Now the readings are tabulated in the given tabular form. This is the red color. I am going to write the red color readings. So this is the left and this is the right. This is the MSR VC. This is the MSR VC. So on the left side, the main scale reading of red color is 44 and its vernier coincidence is 5. Similarly, on the right side, the main scale reading of red color is 224 and its vernier coincidence is 23. Similarly, by moving the telescope, place the y-axis on the yellow color, take the readings for yellow, left, right. By moving the telescope, place the y-axis on the green color, take the readings of green color on the left side as well as on the right side. Next one, place the y-axis on the red blue color, take the readings for blue on right and left side. Finally, place the y-axis on the violet color, take the readings for violet on the left side as well as on the right side. These are the minimum deviation position readings of various colors. Red color readings, yellow color minimum deviation position readings, green color, blue color, violet color. After obtaining these readings, remove the prism from the prism table. Try to come back with help of telescope. Place the y-axis on the narrow slit. Now the y-axis is placed on the narrow slit. After placing the y-axis on the narrow slit, take the readings. Those readings are called as direct readings on the left side as well as on the right side. On the left side, the 0th revision of vernier scale is coinciding with 5.5 of main scale, hence the MSR value is 5.5. Whereas the 15th division of vernier is coinciding with one of the main scale division, hence the VC value equal to 15. Similarly, on the right side, the 0th division of vernier is coinciding with
185.5 of main scale, hence the main scale reading value equal to 185.5, whereas the 10th division of vernier scale is coinciding with one of the main scale, hence the VC value is 10. These readings are tabulated in the given tabular form. These are the direct readings. This is the left one, 5.5 main scale and 15 is the vernier. And next one, 185.5 and 10. These are the direct readings of our experiment. Now I am going to calculate the RL and RR values. To obtain the RL and RR values, we have to use this formula, that is MSR plus VC into LC. So I am going to take the wild color readings. MSR value is 46 plus VC value is 20 into LC is 1/60 degrees, which is equal to 46.33. Similarly, on the right side of violet color, MSR plus VC into LC, so which is equal to 226 main scale plus 17 into 1/60. By simplifying this value, we will get 226.28. These readings are tabulated in this tabular form. So left side RL value is 46.33, right side RR value is 226.28. Similarly, we can find out all these RL and RR values of various colors. After obtaining RL and RR values, these are the RL values and these are the RR values. After obtaining these values, we have to take difference of these two. So the difference of these two, which gives the L value 38.33. Similarly, the difference of these two gives the 38.72. After that, the difference of the direct reading and minimization reading, difference of these two gives the 38.8. Next one, the difference of these two, which is equal to 39.15. Similarly, we can measure L and R values and are tabulated in the given tabular form. These are the L and R values of various colors. After obtaining these L and R values, we have to take the average of those two. It gives the deviation angle of particular color. So here the average of these two equal to 40.6. This is the deviation angle of violet color. Next, this is 40.03. This is the deviation angle of blue color. Next, this is the deviation angle of green color. Next, this is the deviation angle of yellow color. And finally, this is the deviation angle of red color. So these are the deviation angles of various colors. Here the violet color is having more deviation value, 40.06. Next one is 40.03, 39.59. So 38.97, 38.52. By observing these values, we can say that the violet color deviates more than the red color. Then I am going to determine the refraction index of various colors. To determine the refraction index of various colors, we have to use this formula, that is mu equals sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2. Now I am going to find out the refraction index of violet color, which is equal to sin of 60 plus 40.6 by 2 by sin 60 by 2, which is equal to 1.538. And this reading is tabulated in the given tabular form, which is equal to 1.538. Similarly, we can measure the refraction indices values of various colors. These are the refraction indices values of various colors. After obtaining these refraction indices, I am going to select any two refraction indices values. Let it be blue and red, blue color and red color. Now I am going to find out the dispersed power value by using this formula, that is omega equal to mu b difference mu r by mu b plus mu r by 2 minus 1. So here mu b value is mu b value is 1.532, difference mu r 1.51 by 1.532 plus 1.51 by 2 minus 1. By simplifying this, we will get 0.04. this is the dispersive power value of material of a prism. This value can be written in the result column, that is 0.04. Now the dispersive power value of prism is equal to 0.04. After obtaining the dispersed power value, we have to go for velocities of various colors. To find out the velocities of various colors, we have to approach this formula C equal to mu v, and next one v equal to C by mu. By using this formula, we can determine the velocities of various colors. First, I am going to find out the velocity of violet color v equal to C means 3 × 10⁸ by refract index value, so 1.538. By simplifying this, we will get the velocity of violet color, which is equal to 1.948 × 10⁸. 1.948 × 10⁸ meter per second. Similarly, we can find out the velocity values of all the 5 colors. These are the velocity values of various colors. The velocity of violet color is 1.948 × 10⁸. The velocity of blue color is 1.958 × 10⁸. Velocity of green is 1.96 × 10⁸. Velocity of yellow is 1.973 × 10⁸. Finally, the velocity of red color is 1.98 × 10⁸ meter per second. By observing these values, we can say that the red color velocity is more than the velocity of violet color. So here, this is the way to find out the refractive indices, dispersive power, and velocities of various colors. Precautions or safety measures. The first one is, while placing the prism on the prism table, don't touch the well polished surfaces or smooth surfaces. That is, it should be handled by its edges like this. Second one is, during the recording of observations, avoid the parallax error. Thank you for watching this video.